this press conference. We are truly happy about the teams here to share this thoughts and experience from today's match. My name is Juan Moreno, and I will be guiding us through today's proceedings. We have a packed agenda, so let's start. First, I'd like to introduce Genji. So right now we are going to open the floor for questions from the media. Please raise your hand and I will call you on you. Please remember also when asking your question, please state your name and the outlet you represent. We're going to start with Snape.
Yes. Hi, I'm Snape from Sportskeeda Esports. First of all, commiserations on the loss, guys. My question is for Munchkin. So I wanted to talk about the second map because it seemed like you had a great grip on Lotus, but things sort of started to slip in the second half. So what would you say allowed Heretics to make a comeback and win that map specifically?
먼치켄 선수에게 드리는 질문인데요. 로터스에 대해서 물어보고 싶은데 젠지가 리드를 잡고 있다가 후반전부터 헤리틱스가 따라왔잖아요. 좀 어떤 부분이 헤리틱스가 승리를 가져가게 된 요인이었는지 궁금합니다. 로터스에서.
일단 헤리틱스가 전체적으로 운영을 잘했다고 생각을 하고요. 그리고 저희한테 좋은 기회가 왔었는데 저희가 그 기회들을 잘 살리지 못한 게 좀 패배의 요인이라고 생각합니다.
They had really good plans going into the second half in terms of their macro especially. But I think we had a lot of good opportunities to close out Lotus, but we just missed them. So thus, Heretics win.
Recording in progress.
Okay, next. Okay. Yep. Next question is from Siddharth.
Hello. Hello. Commiserations on the loss, guys. I would like to ask this question to anyone who wants to answer. On the third map, Bind, we saw Heretics bring out a very different team comp. Did this catch you off guard? Were you prepared enough for it? And would you say that that was the reason why Bind fell out of your hands?
아무나 대답해 주시면 되는데 바인드에서 헤리틱스가 좀 조합을 바꿔들고 왔습니다. 확실히 젠지가 준비했던 부분이 많이 안 통했거나 아니면은 조합을 바꿔들고 왔기 때문에 뭔가 더 읽기 힘들었을까요?
일단 딱히 읽는 부분에선 어려움은 없었다고 생각을 하는데 저희가 2세트에서 확실히 컴백을 좀 당했기 때문에 3세트 때 조금 저희 플레이가 조금 저조했다고 생각을 하고 그냥 아쉽게 된 것 같아요.
No, it didn't make it really particularly hard for me to read them, but it's just that we allowed Heretics to come back on the second map. So energy-wise, we weren't really feeling that well going into Bind, and it's just a bummer match.
Okay, thank you, and good luck in the next game.
Thank you for your question. Next question is from Strafe Esports.
Hi, thank you. I'm Casey from Strafe Esports. First of all, I'd like to say sorry for the loss. This question is for either Lakia or Munchkin. So due to the, loss of rounds on your side, we saw some visible frustrations on the team. Do you think that was because of some mental toll on the team, or do you think that there were other factors as well?
라키아 선수 아니면 먼치킨 선수께서 말씀을 해주시면 되는데 오늘 전체적으로 젠지가 카메라에 잡혔을 때 좀 답답한 표정이 많이 드러났거든요. 좀 이게 멘탈적인 측면에 있어서 그렇게 좀 답답했던 건지 아니면은 뭔가 좀 경기력이 막히는 다른 요소가 있었는지 궁금합니다.
뭐 두 가지 다 있었다고 생각을 하는데 뭐 저희가 뭐 실제로 멘탈도 굉장히 조금 좀 오늘 흔들렸던 것 같고 그리고 저희가 오늘 게임을 하는데 일단 전체적으로 가스가 좀 많이 나오거든요, 경기장 전체에. 근데 실제로 저희가 좀 숨 쉬는데 답답하기도 하고 모니터 화면에도 많이 좀 가려지기 때문에 그 부분이 좀 3세트 전까지는 좀 심했고 3세트 때는 조금 보완이 됐던 것 같습니다.
I think it's a little bit of both. I do agree that we didn't have the best mental for today's game, but we had other aspects such as we have a lot of smokes in the arena because of the smoke machine, and it did make us hard to breathe. It did get better in the third map, but it just makes everything foggy. We can't really look at the monitor clearly, and just overall, it was that external aspect as well.
All right, thank you.
Thank you. Next question is from Sierra.
Yeah, hello. Sierra, just freelance. My question, maybe we can just go down the table and each can answer really quickly, which is after your loss against Heretics, you'll obviously be going up against either FPX or Sentinels for that last spot in playoffs out of your group. Who do you think is going to win, and that'll be who you're facing off against?
아무나 대답해 주시면 되는데 이제 FPX 아니면 센티널스를 만나야 되잖아요. 그중에서 누가 이겨서 젠지를 만나러 올것 같은지 대답 부탁드립니다.
뭐 누가 이길지 잘 모르겠어가지고 저는 센티넬이랑 FPX 반반 싸움인 것 같아서 저희는 뭐 아무나 올라와도 네, 거기에 맞춰서 열심히 할 생각입니다.
I genuinely don't know. I think it's a coin flip between Sentinels and FPX. They both have a chance, but it doesn't really matter who comes to play us next because we'll be whoever it is, whoever we're up against, we'll just try to prep our best game and play our best game.
오케이, okay, next question is from 카르사.
哦哦，hello，我这里是中国的观众啊，就是想问一下指挥 Much King 啊，在图三就是看到 TH 阵容发生变化，第一时间发现这个阵容，跟之前打的是不一样，就对面的阵容变了，就 TH 的阵容变了，然后是怎么想的？有没有慌乱？有没有慌？
The first question, I would like to ask IGL Munchkin, when the in the map 3 bind, you guys noticed TH comp has changed, are you panic, or what do you think of their comp during that time? 원치킨 선수에게 드리는 질문인데 바인드에서 헤레틱스의 조합이 바뀐 걸 봤을 때 반응이 어땠나요? 뭔가 당황했다거나 아니면 어떤 반응이었는지 궁금합니다.
뭐 당연히 저희가 뭐 어느 정도 당황은 했다고 생각은 하는데 뭐그 조합을 뭐 스크림에서 한두 번은 만나봤던 것 같아요. 그래서 상대가 기존 조합으로는 저희를 못 이기겠다고 판단하고 바꿔온 거기 때문에 상대방의 완성도가 그렇게 높지 않을 거라고 생각을 하고 있었고 네, 그냥 저희끼리 좀 무너진 것 같아요.
Yeah, it did throw us off a little bit, but I think we played their comp once or twice in our scrims, and our take on their change of comp was that maybe Heretics brought in a new comp because they knew that we would analyze them and we would be able to beat them with their old comps. So thus we thought maybe they're not 100% comfortable with their new comp that they were running on the bind today, but I think that loss on bind in general was more on us.
其实当时看到他们换阵容的时候是有一点慌乱的。我们其实之前在训练赛也碰到过这个阵容。我觉得他们换阵容可能是觉得我们研究了他们，所以他们。换了一套，临时换了一套新阵容来打我们。我们当时想的是，就是他们换了新阵容之后，是不是不是对新阵容的熟悉度不是那么的高？总之，但是我们觉得他们打得很好。我们觉得我们输掉了 Bind 的这张图，更多的是在我们自己打得不好。
哦，好的，我这边还有个问题想问一下教练啊，就是图一 RBS 就是没见他们之前打过，然后在这之前是不是练了很久啊？这个问题想问到教练。
Okay, the second question is to the coach. For the map 1 Arbis, I haven't noticed you guys play this map during the match. So, do you guys play scrim a lot or practice a lot on this map?
솔로 감독님께 드리는 질문인데요. 젠지가 어비스를 처음으로 공개했는데 스크림이나 이 맵의 준비는 좀 어느 정도로 한 건지 궁금하다고 합니다. 좀 많이 준비된 맵인지.
생각보다 저희가 어비스에 대해서 스크림이나 뭐 연습을 많이 했고요. 근데 뭐 아직까지 완성도는 그렇게 높지 않기 때문에 더 잘할 수 있을 것 같다고 생각하고 있습니다.
Yeah, we did have enough reps in our scrims and practices, but I don't think it's 100% impeccable. So once we get more reps in and clean things up on Abyss, I think we can play better.
确实，我们其实，在私下和训练赛都练过这张图，但是其实我觉得我们队伍对这张图的熟练度还没有那么的高。我们会再继续练习之后，当我觉得我们队伍是更加适应这张图的话，我们会选择这张图的。
Thank you.
Thank you. Next question is from Arna.
Data is commiseration on the loss. My question is for Coach Solo. After a loss like this, what goes behind the scenes for the coaching staff and as well as the players to reset and come back, especially after you guys have been playing pretty dominantly. Does this loss gives a a good wake-up call for not being comfortable in the tournament, and especially at this stage where the stakes are so high?
솔로 감독님께 드리는 질문인데요. 이런 패배 이후에 코칭 스태프는 이제 다음 경기를 위해서 어떻게 준비할 예정인지, 그리고 젠지가 워낙 압도적인 흐름을 가져가고 있었기 때문에 이번 패배가 좀 선수들 멘탈에 어떤 영향을 줄지 궁금하다고 합니다.
어쨌든 뭐 센티넬 아니면 에피펙스가 올라올 거둘중한 팀이 올라오기 때문에 그리고 결정이 나면은 거기에 맞춰서 뱀픽을 준비해서 그 맵을 열심히 준비할 거고 뭐 선수들 뭐 이제 한 경기 졌다고 해서 멘탈이 흔들릴 만한 선수들이 아니기 때문에 네. 다음 경기도 멘탈 회복해서 네. 좋은 경기 하겠습니다.
Well, it's either going to be Sentinels or FPX. So once we get to see who we'll face next, we will work on our map vetoes and prepare those maps as well and make sure that we put in the best prep we can. And I don't think the players we have here, they don't have the type of mentality that will kind of die down or crumble just because of one loss. I think they can reset and come back stronger.
Thank you and all the best for the next match.
Thank you. Next questions from Pedro Romero.
Guys, likewise, commiserations. I got a question for Solo. Given all of the things that's been talking about so far during this press conference, what do you feel is the one thing that the team could have done differently in this entire series against Heretics from your point of view?
솔로 감독님께 드리는 질문인데요. 오늘 경기 돌아봤을 때좀 하나만 고칠 수 있다면 어떤 점일까요?
저희가 이번에 뭐 바인드도 그렇고 로터스도 그렇고 뭐 상대방이 총이 짧다면 총이 짧고 길다면 길고 뭐 약간 한두 명은 총이 길고 다른 그 선수들은 총이 짧은데 그런 라운드에서 저희가 굉장히 많이 졌다고 생각을 하기 때문에 그런 부분을 좀 잘했었다면은 충분히 쉽게 이겼을 것 같고요. 네, 그런 부분에서 잘 보완해야 될것 같습니다.
Well, on Bind and also on Lotus, there were rounds where Team Heretics had, the Vandals or the Phantoms, or some of them did not have the full weaponry choices. And those were the rounds when we weren't able to adapt quite quickly or read what they were going to do. So we really needed to, we had to read them better when it comes to those non-gun rounds.
Thanks so much. Last questions come from Kaus that money.
Thank you. So this question is for Munchkin, but any of the other players also free to answer. So you played TH last time in Shanghai, and compared to that match, TH are now playing with their full squad with Minibu in the roster. So did you feel or see any differences in their approach to the match and the game, and also any differences in their play style as well?
원식이 선수에게 드리는 질문인데 다른 선수분들이 대답을 해주셔도 되고요. 일단 헤리틱스를 상하이 때는 꺾었는데 이번에는 미니부 선수가 들어간 원래대로의 베스트 5 로스터를 상대했잖아요. 좀 플레이 스타일적으로나 아니면은 뭐 게임에 대한 해석이 크게 달라졌다고 느끼는 부분이 있을까요?
일단 상하이 결승 때는 충분히 파티텍 선수도 잘해줬기 때문에 팀 헤틱스는 그때도 강했다고 생각은 하는데요. 확실히 미니부 선수가 들어오고 요원 폭이 되게 넓어졌기 때문에 조금 다가오는 방향성 같은 게 많이 달라진 지금 팀이라고 생각을 하고, 네, 잘한 것 같아요.
Props to Petr Cech because he played extremely well in the grand finals. They were a strong team back then as well, but with Minibu joining their team and with them playing in a full roster, I think it gives them a lot of more options when it comes to the agent pool. So they definitely have a different approach to the game.
All right. Thank you very much, and all the best for your upcoming matchup.
Thank you. So we have one question here in the room.
Hello and commiserations for the for your loss. I have a question to the coach Solo. Everyone was excited to see your interpretation of the this map. So, and as expected, you can see the amount of effort and thought put into this. Especially, I was impressed by like multi-layered post-plan protection. So I would like to hear like how satisfied you are with the comp, macro, and execution in today's match. If you can't go into many details, maybe you can tell us percentage-wise. And also, how well do you think Heretics were reacting to your tactics? Thank you.
솔로 감독님께 드리는 질문인데 어비스에서 젠지가 준비를 많이 한게 확실히 티가 났고 특히나 포스트 플랜을 보는 재미가 있었는데요. 어비스 전체적으로 뭔가 조합에 있어서 경기력에 있어서 운영에 있어서 그리고 얼마나 잘그 준비된 조합과 그 전략들을 사용했는지에 있어서 어떻게 평가하시는지 그리고 뭔가 퍼센트로 나타내 주실 수 있다면 몇 퍼센트 라고 평가를 하시는지 그리고 팀 헤레틱스가 이런 젠지의 어비스에 얼마나 잘 대처한 것 같은지 궁금합니다.
질문이 굉장히 많은데
일단 어떻게 평가하시나요? 어비스 경기나 뭔가 준비해 온 것들?
일단 저희가 준비한 대로는 잘 흘러갔고 좀 실수가 많이 나오긴 했지만 그래도 저희가 이겼기 때문에 네. 그쪽도 실수를 많이 했기도 했고 저희도 많이 했지만 저희가 준비한 대로 잘 먹힌 것도 많았고 네. 경기에 있어서는 만족하고 있습니다.
몇 퍼센트 정도 주시겠어요?
우리도 이겼으니까 한 70%? 80% 정도? 네. 그리고 또 뭐였죠?
아, 헤레틱스는 젠지의 어비스에 얼마나 잘 대처한 것 같으신가요?
저쪽 팀은 저희가 공개된 게 없기 때문에 사실 헤레틱이 좀더 힘들었을 거라고 생각을 하거든요. 근데 생각보다 확실히 잘하는 팀이라고 생각하고 있습니다. 네.
As to how he would rate the Abyss, he's pretty satisfied, mostly because they won. So he would give it a 70 to 80% on how satisfied he is with the overall performance and the macro and the executions on the map. There were a lot of mistakes, but they did play their best game when it comes to executing as well. And Team Heretics were making a lot of mistakes on their side as well. But overall, they did what they prepped for, and it was a good map for them. And for your second question, Team Heretics did not have any VODs on Gen G and their Abyss, so it was going to be more difficult for them to play this map against Gen G, but he thinks they did pretty well.
네, 너무 감사합니다. Good luck.
Okay. Thank you to G2, to Gen.G for being here, for your insight from being here today. Your determination and sportsmanship are commendable. We look forward to seeing your future matches and success.